The poodle has been sedated, and you can see the hair, the biting on the legs, this part. And the lower part as well, turn upside down and turn up like that. Turn the leg up. Yeah. You can see this ringworm. Ringworm on the side there. Yeah, turn up somewhere. And the vulva is very itchy, this part. It's indicating it, so there will be some infection in the urinary tract. And overall, you can see actually seems to be biting, biting here. So and there is inner sac infection as I express inner sac already. So it's really not only the ears, but other parts. The ears, of course, the ear canal is not open; it's closed. So the owner wants fast, so we're trying to finish it within an hour and let the dog go home. Now this one is a 7-year-old, and there's some tartar here. Let's check for any scabies or not. Scabies, there'll be some crustiness of the ears, ear edges. Overall, there's lots of dandruff from this dog. So this is part of the ringworm. Ringworm and bacteria itchiness. The neck, is it the owner does not agree, but actually the neck also, you can see a lot of dandruff and scratching. This could be bacteria and ringworm as well. So in August, which is about 2 months ago, he saw another vet, but he wasn't satisfied with the treatment, so he came back again. Because skin disease has been treated more detailed rather than just give some antibiotics and painkillers. They will include, especially ringworm, they include clipping board, the whole hair, whole body, so that the owner can clean up. Now you can see even the eyes, so there's some scratching. Now the reason we have to sedate the dog is because when the dog moves and the dog gets clipper cuts or burns, the owner is very unhappy. And so to prevent all sorts of clipping injuries in a dog which is already very itchy, so we prefer to give a slight sedation and quickly clipboard and then do ear irrigation, inner sac expression, then the legs clip as well as possible. This is due to biting, self-biting. So you can understand that just simple injection and some tablets has given by the first vet in August. Now it's October. Was not effective, according to the owner, as compared to my previous treatment. That was around April. Now it's October, and that treatment was, according to him, effective because he came back 1 month later and was told that the ear was okay. After that, he did not use the ear ointment anymore. So the problem came back again. For poodles with 40 years and chronic ear infection, 2 times or 3 times a week ear cleaning is important. For Bayer Vets, October 12 to 05, Monday.